All right, let's talk about the navigation landmark. It is one of the most important landmarks you can have on a website because the internet is basically a connection of pages that are connected via links. So what the navigation is just a collection of links to help users navigate a website, web page, go outside the web page, navigate inside the web page with local anchors, and so on. So the navigation landmark is not a top-level landmark. That means it can be included in other landmarks, usually within header. I usually include it in header, main, or content info, also known as the footer. You can have multiple navigation landmarks on one page. Here I am on the Wise website, and I want to show you that they actually have multiple navigations. So if I open up my on-screen keyboard and I open my plugin that I use to navigate to landmarks too. And if I start tabbing, they have skip link and language selector navigation, and they also have meta and search navigation, and they have a main navigation. So it is perfectly normal to have many navigations in big websites. They have many navigations. So you're probably thinking, well, how do users differentiate with that? Well, they're probably using area label or area labeled by. If we inspect the element for the main navigation, they're using an area label called main, but you can also use area labeled by if you have a visible label, which I'm going to show you in a little bit. You can have multiple navigations just to make sure that they separate them. And so one thing I want to mention is a lot of people, when they're using the nav element, they make the mistake of adding it as a row of menu. Do not do this, okay? Because the area authoring privacy have navigation menu button example, and this is wrong. This is not only the menu button example, but have the menu example, how to create a menu for a website. And it is really, really deceptive because it says it can be, people start to think that this is how menus are supposed to be, you know, menu or menu bar. What a web navigation is. Absolutely never use raw menu bar, never use raw menu item. If I see this, no cookie for you. I am really, really adamant about this. And not only me, a lot of web accessibility specialists have said do not use raw menu. This is only used if you want to create a desktop type of a menu that the user can navigate using the arrow keys on the keyboard. But in my 10 plus years as a web developer, I have never had the need to create a menu like that. So if you want to create a menu with the navigation, use nav. And then just use the nav element if you're on HTML5, and then just use an unordered list, like I have done here with my accessible hamburger navigation. So it's pretty straightforward. But don't use raw menu item. I made that mistake before when I was young and green, but I'm not doing it anymore. I want to show you an accessible menu that I have created with the nav element. So you're probably wondering why my nav element has a button. Well, the button is actually the mobile hamburger that appears on mobile or when the users have zoomed in the page. So always include the hamburger inside the navigation, because when you're navigating the website with the screen reader, you want the screen reader to say navigation, you know, navigation menu collapsed or navigation menu expanded. So that's what I've done. But if we just close the menu, I usually do header. This is for the main navigation header. And then the child of the header is the nav. And the nav contains an unordered list. This is important because it is semantic to put all the links in the navigation unordered list, because this is what semantically they are. It's a list of links in an unordered order. And then I just have the li list item and the I. That's it. And I might also add area current that we're going to learn about later, but basically that means which page you're currently on. This is helpful for screen readers, but this is optional. And this is very simple. See, no extra rows or, you know, menu items, just very simple navigation, unordered list. And if your navigation is very long and you need to hide it on mobile and to have a hamburger menu, just add a button inside the navigation. So right here, I want to show you how I usually do it. You know, I use the nav. So you can either use nav by itself, or you can use row navigation. Update 2022. It is no longer recommended that you add an explicit row navigation if you're using the nav element. Or if you're using HTML5, what you could do is do div row navigation. And there we go. Simple as that. Now, if you have multiple navigations, so for example, let's say we have a main navigation and we also have a navigation inside the footer. So let me add a navigation in the footer. All right, so right now we have two links excuse me, you have two navigation on the same side. The same side. First is the header navigation, and then we have the footer navigation. The footer navigation is social media, so it has the social media links, and the header one is just, you know, normal navigation to navigate. So I want to show you how screen readers detect multiple navigation with names and without names. Remember how we talked about accessible name, the area label on landmarks, or the area labeled by, or just any name you give an accessible name to a landmark is also called, you know, an accessible name. So I have right now two landmarks, and both of them have, each of them has a different name. So this one has nav2 and this one has a label of main. So let me open the page where they rendered
the HTML.
For this test, I'm using Narrator on Chrome screen reader. I'm going to open the landmark elements list. I'm on Narrator. So I'm going to press caps lock plus F5 to open the elements list.
Search landmarks window, search list, banner, one of four, selected.
Over here, we have main navigation and we have nav2, which is the social media or the footer navigation. If I try to go to the main navigation using the arrow keys, so I'm pressing arrow key down now.
Main navigation, two of four.
There we go. The screen reader is announcing it as a navigation.
Nav2, navigation, four of four.
There we go. Now let's try to see what happens if we remove the names from our navigations.
Index.a, scan, enter list, bullet.
Okay, now I'm going to turn on my elements list again for Narrator.
Search landmarks window, search list, no items found.
Here we have no items found. So for some reason, it's not detecting the banner and the content, but it's not detecting any landmark. So I guess we confused it because we have two navs that has no name. And I guess the screen reader just got confused and just didn't show any landmark whatsoever. Let me turn off my screen reader. Now, if we look at our plugin, it still says banner, navigation, and then it says navigation. Now, this is very difficult for users to navigate because they have two navigations, but they don't know which one of them users can go to, okay? Because they don't have an accessible name. That's why accessible name for navigations are so important. So that's pretty much what I wanted to tell you about navigation. It's very important that you label them. If you have multiple navigations, are used for the main navigation, for example, the header. It's also used in the footer. If you have two navigations that has the exact same links, for example, a lot of people would add a navigation in the footer that is the exact same as the navigation in the header, then you add the same area label or the same accessible name for both navigations. You can add navigation for a sidebar, pagination, main navigation. These are the navigations off the top of my head. Just because you have a list of links, though, doesn't mean you need a navigation. For example, if you're listing a list of links where people can find useful to learn more about birds, you know, in an article about birds, that's not a navigation. It's just a list of links. So be careful not to abuse this landmark. A best practice for labeling navigations, if there is a visible label, it is best to use this one. For example, our footer navigation has an H2 code social media. So instead of adding an area label code social media, that will just make screen readers repeat themselves. So there's going to say heading level 2 social media, and it's going to say navigation social media. What you can do is instead of area label, add area labeled by, and then just add an ID. For example, we're going to add an ID of social and just connect it. Like this. There we go. Social. If you're browsing the website top to bottom, or if you started the footer, unfortunately the area labeled by will make the screen repeat itself, because first it will encounter the H2 and then it will encounter the nav with the area labeled by. So that means it will repeat the heading twice. Unfortunately, there's nothing to do about that, but we're adding the area labeled by because we want to keep our code, you know, in a don't repeat yourself pattern. And if users jump to the landmarks with their screen reader, the nav will have a separate name. So still repeat itself with area labeled by, but it is better pattern than just using area label and repeating the text twice. And then for the main navigation, usually in the header, it doesn't have a visible label. So it is more appropriate just to add a main navigation code. Main. Now, I've seen a lot of people adding, for example, they add in the area label main navigation, or they add, for example, social media navigation. This is redundant because screen readers will announce the name of the landmark. They're going to say navigation anyway. So if you have main navigation, the screen is going to say main navigation, navigation. Now, let's try to see if that will work. Let me turn on NVDA.
Banner landmark main navigation navigation landmark list with three items home link.
Notice how it repeated the name, the word navigation. Let's go down.
About content info landmark social media navigation navigation landmark list with three items Facebook link.
There we go. So no need to repeat the name of the landmark inside of it with the area label or related label. Bye. And this is the end of the lesson. This lecture is part of the ARIA course I have on Udemy available for purchase. It is the highest rated course in the accessibility section on Udemy and it has 4.8 stars and over 100 students. Feel free to enroll and ask me any questions that you have. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video. You can find links to my courses in the description of this video. Thank you.